today's financial editor, and she's also the author of Money 911. David Bach is getting a little inappropriate. He's also the founder of FinishRich.com and the author of Debt Free for Life. Well, you got to show Sharon Epperson some love too, David. She's a personal finance correspondent for CNBC and CNBC.com. Good to see everybody.
Nice to see you.
Okay, before we get in any more trouble, let's go to Skype. We've got Deb. She's called.
Really, really good question, but you have it kind of backwards. The FHA has adjusted because prices have already gone down. So
Okay, thanks so much for the question, Deb. We've got an email question. This one, who doesn't?
How do you get free money? So there's a break out both of those options, but the best one's obviously the grant.
Okay. And the even better one is a scholarship, right? Fastweb.com.
Sure.
Look there for and figure out how you can get your resume up to speed to qualify for one of those scholarships.
And we'll put all those websites on today.com so you can access those a little bit later on. Another email question, this one. They know they need to do it.
They know they need to do it. That's a great place to start. You start. Where are you going to put that short-term savings? And at least 10% per month from your paycheck, put that in an online savings account. Automate it. You don't have to think about it. Go to bankrate.com, moneyrates.com, other good website to go to figure out what may have the best rate. And then look at some of that budgeting software or online tools that are out there. I like mint.com, bundle.com is another one to go for. But the real point is to save for something. And that's what you need to start.
And
probably rainy day is the good way to start. The emergency fund is the first place to start.
The deal with saving money and the reason that 401ks work is because the money comes out first. If you can't see it
and you can't touch it,
you won't spend it.
And that is the number one way Americans build wealth is using their 401k plan. So if they don't,
we've got Kristen. She's calling in from Tucson, Arizona.
On all the cards and put the additional funds just towards one card at a time, and then once that card is paid off, use that amount.
Okay, well, let's get Jean's
take. The second way is going to get you out of debt faster. You want to put all your additional money toward not just one card, but the highest interest rate card. And then once that card's paid off, you want to move the additional money toward the next card with the highest interest rate while making the minimum payments on the rest so that you're never late. I love that they now have these guidelines on credit card statements that say, if you want to get out of debt in 3 years, pay this much money. It's a great guideline.
The credit card company's actually doing something good.
They are, but you want to make sure that you pay off your highest rate card first. It's just going to get you out fastest and cheapest.
Okay, we want to get to another viewer on the phone. This is Marie.
Home loan modification under the Making Home Affordable program. We're working hard to get all of our debts current. However, we right now have a bad credit.
It'll go up 50 to 100 points in less than a year.
All right. Thank you very much for your question. And we, of course, want to thank Gene Chatsky, David Bach, and Sharon Epperson. For those of you on the East Coast,